Good morning. Wait, Ben is already up. Am I late again, or is he waking up on his own these days? Does this mean I'm of no use? Oh wait, is this my natural substitute? The body clock. Do you want to know more about the body clock and how it works? Stick around and watch the video until the end. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to support your favorite bestie channel. The body clock is also known as the circadian clock. It is a natural internal clock that keeps track of time. The word circadian comes from circa diem, which means around a day. For humans, it is for about 24.5 hours. But that doesn't mean your body clock can add half an hour extra to your day. Sorry if you were looking for some extra time for your last week's unfinished project. It means that if your body is kept in total darkness, your body will continue working on a 24-hour long day fashion. Provided that you aren't too scared to function in the dark. Individual cells will still show timely changes in gene expression to keep track of time. But without any cues, you will drift every day by half an hour. I wouldn't try using this excuse on your boss, however. Your body has machinery in place to track time. But it happens at the speed of a mechanical clock. It is a little slow. Therefore, you need an actual clock, like me, to adjust your physiology according to the day and night cycle. But why do you need an internal clock at all, you might wonder? The answer is to predict. Having a built-in clock prevents you from being completely dependent on the environment. It gives you the control to function independently without being passive toward environmental changes. You are able to predict and not just assume it's nighttime when the room is dark. A disturbed body clock can directly affect your sleep cycle. You might end up feeling sleep deprived, which can have harmful effects over a long period of time. To know more about the effects of sleep deprivation on your body, watch our video linked down below. Now, let's dive into how it functions. It was known for a long time that your daily rhythms are well regulated. But the exact location of this so-called clock was still unknown. During an experiment in the mid-20th century, scientists took out a small part of a hamster's brain. This was called a suprachiasmatic nucleus, or SCN. This resulted in the hamster losing its ability to maintain a body rhythm. The rhythm production is a complex process. In simpler words, you can say that the suprachiasmatic nucleus, situated right above the point of the optic nerve fibers, has specialized clock genes. These genes are responsible for coding certain proteins. If these proteins, along with other regulatory proteins, are present in amounts more than a threshold level, they switch off the clock genes. A kind of feedback mechanism. When the level of protein drops over time, the genes are switched on again, thus, in turn, restarting the rhythmic cycle. This was all we knew until a recent study. The Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine 2017 was awarded to Jeffrey C. Hall, Michael Rosbash, and Michael W. Young for their discoveries of molecular mechanisms controlling the circadian rhythm. A fruit fly was the first multicellular organism the body clock was discovered in. Yes, those little guys hovering around your rotten banana. In 1971, Seymour Benzier and his student Ronald Konopka discovered faults in the internal clocks of fruit flies. They traced back the mutation responsible for this fault in a particular gene. This gene was named PER. This is where our Nobel Prize winners stepped in. Jeffrey Hall and Michael Rosbash started studying the PER gene in 1984. Their work, along with Michael Young's, detailed multiple body clock gene levels rising and falling over a time period of 24 hours. This study contributed significantly toward our understanding of a body clock's functioning. But the clock is not only genetically regulated, there's more to it. It is also dependent on environmental factors, such as light and dark. Light acts as a reset signal. This keeps the organism in sync with the world outside. Internal awakening might sound like a very real concept right now, doesn't it? But, despite common perception, the clock is not only responsible for regulating your sleep cycle, it also governs the functioning of other systems such as hunger, mental alertness, heart functioning, immunity, mood, and stress. Yup, the mastermind behind everything is this clock, the one you were probably paying the least attention to. Even in the case of self-regulated organs like the heart, it plays a major role in controlling certain fluctuation, such as blood sugar level. The heart relies on the clock for certain cues. The genetic factor responsible for controlling the heart's electrical signal and clock rhythm is the same. Such an understanding of the heart-clock connection has helped researchers in drug designing. It has been noticed that heart problems such as fatal arrhythmias are more likely to occur during morning hours and less likely in the evening. This is the reason behind the consumption of blood pressure medications in the evening time. This way, they function in sync with your body's circadian rhythms and gives effective results. So don't miss out on your morning pills. Similar to sleep cycle and heart functions, the clock regulates hunger and metabolism through hormones too. Even the immunity and inflammatory responses are regulated in a similar fashion. It promotes the secretion of compounds involved in causing inflammation at night. This is why you always get fevers during the evening. This happens because infections are fought better while the body is at rest. All your energy can be utilized for this rather than other functions. Similarly, the clock also reduces the activity of the stress hormone cortisol at night, assisting in the immune response. But when should we listen to our body clock and when to our wristwatches? What happens if there's a mismatch in our internal and external time? Well, a lot. Such a mismatch is prominently seen in the case of jet lag and shift work. These phenomena go against our regular patterns and can disturb physical and mental health. Studies show a higher rate of traffic accidents and injuries when there is a loss or excess of an hour's sleep. Disrupting the clock can also increase the risk of myocardial infarction, diabetes, and cognitive decline. So time to scrap your Outlook calendar and start listening to the one you have built in. Do you listen to your body clock when you're sleepy or hungry? Let us know in the comment section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or the right video and enjoy.